So I was just leaving to do the pig report, and there's a boar right in this creek. He was right in front of my house. There he is. I don't know if you saw that. There he goes. Anyway, I'm gonna head off and try to find the other pigs. There he is again. Hey guys, the Pro Rancher here again. It is Saturday, June 9th, 2012, and this is going to be my final pig report for the next week. I shouldn't say final, but not gonna be doing a pig report for the rest of the week for two reasons. One, I've just got some personal family stuff to deal with for the next couple weeks, or for the next couple days. And then we've also got pig hunters coming on Thursday, the 14th. So I want to kind of lay low on the pigs and not put too much pressure on them for the next few days to make our hunting a little bit easier. So yeah, I just wanted to do this one last video here until next week. And hopefully the next video I put out will be pig hunts. And I can't guarantee anything as far as a time frame, but we got hunters Thursday. And I think they're booked Thursday, Friday, and Saturday just in case they can't seem to get them. Anyway, I just showed you a clip of a boar, and here's another one that I just found in the barley. Probably the same one I saw the other night. Anyway, so I got a couple questions I want to answer from you guys, and then I'll sign off for the night. Okay, so Lemmick1900 asked me, how do I get access to the internet since I'm off the grid? Particularly, how do I upload videos and handle YouTube stuff? Well, like a lot of people, wireless. It's all satellite. So that's a pretty standard answer. Anyway, there goes our pig. He's taking off. It's getting dark, otherwise I'd take a drive around and try to find the other ones, but I think they're on the other side of the ranch. Anyway, there goes that pig. Okay, Roe Maverick asked me, what caliber do I recommend for pigs? I'm assuming you meant what cartridge. That's kind of up to the hunter. I wouldn't go anything below like 243. You know, I personally think that guys that are using like 223, you know, 5.56 stuff or with their ARs, I just don't think that's appropriate for a big game. But hey, if you're a crack shot and you can get a heart shot or a head shot every time and knock them dead, you know, that's fine with me. I particularly like to use like a 270, 280. My boss, for example, uses his 7mm mag, and you know that thing really knocks him down. We've had hunters bring their 300 Winchester Magnums, and those things are way too big, in my opinion. You know, I think it's just a waste of meat. It just blows too big of a hole. So you know, something small, something kind of medium, mid range. You know, I think a 270 is like a perfect round. That's my personal preference. Anyway, let's see, next question. Rob Gillespie, how does the ranch compare to New Zealand high country? Well, I can't really answer that question. that's going to have to be up to you. I mean, as you can see, here we are. And, you know, yeah, that's up to you. I've never been to New Zealand, so I don't know how it compares. He also asked, how big is the ranch? It is 2,300 acres. It's basically 4 square miles. And, yeah, it's not a huge ranch. I mean, there's ranches that are like millions of acres, but for where I am in this area, it's pretty big. You know, most people in the area that I live would consider that to be unbelievably huge. You know, these people think that, you know, 1 acre of land is a good piece of land, which it is. You know, I'm not going to knock that, but 2,300 acres. Some people say it's small. Some people say it's huge. Anyway, you be the judge. He also asked, what number of cattle do we run? We lease the property out to some folks that run their cattle here. Our primary operation is hunting. So we don't really handle the cattle too much. I do myself. I've done my work with cattle, but you know, I help out with the brandings, and you know, when they get loose and stuff, I don't have any problem going out there and moving them around from pasture to pasture and whatnot. But primarily, we have some cowboys that come up here and they handle their herd, and they run about 75 head, and it's a cow calf. So at any given time, we might have like 150 cows total if you count the cows and the calves. So 75 cows plus their calves, which they don't always have one calf per cow, but basically you can imagine that's pretty much what we're running up here. Also, he asked as far as like sheep and deer and stuff. We don't run, you know, game, so we don't have like a head count on the deer or the sheep. We don't actually have sheep, but maybe out there in New Zealand you guys have sheep, which is cool. I wish we did. That'd be kind of awesome. Anyway, no, so we don't have sheep. Our deer, they're just wild, so you know, their numbers are what they are. You know, we try to count the bucks as we drive around, you know, especially before the season starts, just so we have an idea of what we have to look out for. I don't know, I'd say we might have 30 or 40 bucks on the ranch. 40 being a really high number, in my opinion, for our ranch, but yeah, that's pretty much it. Also, crops. Well, you're looking at it. The barley, that's our crop. We do not harvest it. But I put in a lot of work, a lot of effort, and we spend a decent amount of money growing our barley. And it is specifically for the pigs. We grow it just so the pigs can eat it. We don't care about the grain itself. We don't harvest the grain. We don't harvest it for hay. We have another 50 acres on another part of town that we used to grow hay on. But we had a couple bad years where we, you know, spent whatever $1,000 or $2,000 to plant it, and we didn't get enough rain. And there was no hay to harvest. So we decided, you know what, it's just not worth our effort. So now we actually lease that land out to some other guys that they do make their living off of growing hay. So they've got, you know, properties all over the place that they grow hay on. And, you know, we give them whatever it is. I think it's like 20 acres that they can plant. Anyway, that is it for tonight. There are no pigs to be seen except for the two boars we just saw. By the way, those were two different boars, the one in the beginning was right in front of my house when I got in my truck to come out here. He jumped out of the creek. I jumped out of the car with my camera, and that's what you saw. And then I caught up to him about a quarter mile away after he ran. And then that one we just saw in the barley here was already here, and I think that's the same pig I saw on the last pig report. Anyway, I will see you guys in a week. Hopefully I have a really good couple pig hunt videos coming out. We have two hunters. They're both going for pigs. They're both going to be here at the same time. So there's a chance that I might have one video with two pigs, or I might have two different videos from the same hunt. We'll see. It'll depend on how it all plays out. And anyway, I will look forward to doing that, and I look forward to keeping these videos going. So if you guys still have any more questions, make sure you post them on Facebook or in a direct inbox, or I guess you could Twitter or tweet them to me. One guy said he did that a couple times and I did not get them. So my friend, if you were out there, I did not get your tweet again. And I will send you a message to let you know that. But anyway, those three options, don't leave your questions in the comment section of the video. I will tend to just answer those right then and there. I won't put them on the video. So if you want your question answered, you know, with your name or whatever, your channel name, on the video, please put it in a direct message. Please post it to Facebook or Twitter. All that being said, have a good week. I'll see you guys in a little bit.
Are you gonna shoot that?